Hello everyone, and I welcome you to Banking IQ. And in Banking IQ today, I will discuss the current affairs of 21st of February 2019. The video will be in English, and my name is Kumar Gaurav, and let's start the current affairs. So the first question is, who went past Stephen Fleming to become the highest run scorer in ODIs for New Zealand? So ODIs stand for One Day International, okay? And now Ross Taylor had went ahead of the Stephen Fleming, and he had become now the highest run scorer in One Day International for New Zealand, okay? And Stephen Fleming was the former captain of New Zealand cricket team, and he is currently the coach of CSK, means Chennai Super Kings, okay? And Chennai Super King is an IPL team, so please remember, okay? And Kane Williamson is current captain of New Zealand cricket team, okay? AK Sharma has been reappointed as the director finance of Indian Oil Corporation, and Indian Oil Corporation chairman is Sanjeev Singh. Lieutenant General Dipender Singh Ahuja became the chief of staff of Southern Command. Headquarter of Southern Command is located in. So Lieutenant General Dipender Singh Ahuja had become the chief of staff of Southern Command, and the headquarter of Southern Command is located in Pune, Maharashtra. It's in Pune, Maharashtra. Okay. Who inaugurated the project development of eco circuit Pathana Mitta Gavi Wagamon and Thekadi under the Swadesh Darshan scheme? So Swadesh Darshan scheme is a project of Ministry of Tourism. It was launched by the Ministry of Tourism of India, okay? And this project called development of eco circuit, and this eco circuit is to be developed in Kerala, okay? In Kerala. So it was inaugurated by the Tourism Minister of India, that is KJ Alphonse. Swayat is an initiative to promote startups, women and youth advantage through e-transactions, okay, on government e-marketplace, launched by. So Swayat stand for startups, women and youth advantage through e-transaction, okay, and this was launched by the Commerce and Industry Minister of India, that is Suresh Prabhu. So he is Commerce and Industrial Minister of India, and please remember that he is also the Civil Aviation Minister of India, okay. Please tell me, who is appointed secretary in Civil Aviation Ministry? Comment me the name. The World Day of Social Justice is celebrated annually all over the world on. So the World Day of Social Justice is celebrated on 20th of February, and 11th February is celebrated as the International Day of Women and Girls in Science, and 13th February is celebrated as World Radio Day, okay? And the theme of this year World Day for the Social Justice 2019 was, if you want peace and development, work for social justice. So this was the theme, and theme is very important, so please remember. India's first high-tech forensic lab opened at. So India's first high-tech forensic lab had opened in Dwarka sector of New Delhi. It has been opened in Dwarka sector of New Delhi, okay? And it was launched by the Home Minister of India, that is Rajnath Singh, okay? And the Home Secretary of India is Rajiv Gaba. Prime Minister Narendra Modi flagged off the world's first diesel-to-electric locomotive in. So this was the diesel engine, okay, and which got converted into electric engine, okay? So this is for the first time that a diesel engine has been converted into electric locomotive engine, and Prime Minister Narendra Modi had flagged off this world first diesel to electric locomotive train, okay, engine, okay, and it has been flagged off in Varanasi, and Varanasi is Lok Sabha constituency of Prime Minister Narendra Modi, and it's in Uttar Pradesh. The first set of 4 vessels made at Kochi Shipyard Limited under the deep sea fishing project was launched in which state? So the first set of 4 vessels which was made in Kochi Shipyard Limited, and it is for the deep sea fishing project, okay, and it was launched in Tamil Nadu. It is launched in Tamil Nadu, and Tamil Nadu CM Edappi K. Palaniswamy had launched this, okay, and please remember that the foundation stone was, this project was initiated by Prime Minister Narendra Modi, okay. So this has been launched, okay, and Tamil Nadu capital is Chennai, okay, and Kochi is in Kerala. 79th Indian History Congress will be held in. So 79th Indian History Congress is to be held in Bhopal. It is going to be held in Bhopal, Law College of Bhopal, Law University of Bhopal, and Bhopal is capital of Madhya Pradesh, and Raja Bhoj Airport is in Bhopal, okay. Raja Bhoj Airport is in Bhopal. Which country became 73rd nation to sign framework agreement of ISA? ISA stands for International Solar Alliance. It is headquartered in Gurugram, okay, and the 73rd nation which has signed now the framework agreement of international solar alliance is Saudi Arabia. Is Saudi Arabia, and Saudi Arabia Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman is visiting India, okay, and he is on 2-day official visit, first time official visit to India, okay, so please remember. World Bank, United Nations Women's and DAS to launch 300 crore women livelihood bonds. So World Bank along with United Nations Women and SIDBI, and SIDBI is going to launch 300 crore women livelihood bond. And please remember that SIDBI stand for Small Industrial Development Bank of India, and it is headquartered in Lucknow, and World Bank is headquartered in Washington DC, and United Nations Women is headquartered in New York, and United Nations is also headquartered in New York. 12th Aero India 2019 launched in, so 12th Aero India 2019 was launched in, it's launched in Bengaluru, and it has been launched by the Defense Minister of India, okay, Miss Nirmala Sitharaman has inaugurated this, okay. PM Modi inaugurated Madan Mohan Malviya Cancer Center and Homi Bhabha Cancer Hospital at, so Prime Minister Narendra Modi had inaugurated Madan Mohan Malviya Cancer Center, okay, and the Homi Bhabha Cancer Hospital in Varanasi. In Varanasi, and Varanasi is his Lok Sabha constituency, and he was visiting Varanasi, okay. And please remember that Madan Mohan Malviya is Bharat Ratna, okay. So Madan Mohan Malviya and Atal Bihari Vajpayee both were conferred with Bharat Ratna in 2015, in the year 2015. Malaysia 8-time world champion Nicole David has announced her retirement. She was she is from Malaysia, okay, and she is 8-time world champion, okay, and she was a squash player. She was a squash player, okay. She is Nicole David, and she had now announced her retirement. Which company launched a new micro insurance plan, Micro Bachat? So Micro Bachat has been launched by Life Insurance Corporation of India, okay, LIC of India, and LIC headquartered in Mumbai, and Hemant Bhargava is MD and chairman, okay. MD, he is the managing director and temporary chairman of LIC. Manpreet Singh Badal presented the rupees 1,58,493 crore state budget for the financial year 2019-20. He is finance minister of, so Manpreet Singh Badal has presented the state budget, okay, and the state budget is of rupees 1,58,493 crore, okay, and this is the state budget of Punjab, okay, so he is the finance minister of Punjab, and Punjab capital is Chandigarh, okay, and Chandigarh is also the capital of Haryana, means Chandigarh is a union territory, okay, and please remember that Punjab CM is Amrinder Singh, and the governor is BP Singh Badnor, and Punjab had recently declared a state aquatic animal as the Indus River Dolphin. So Indus River Dolphin is declared as the Punjab state aquatic animal. Who laid foundation stone of the Hast Silp complex in New Delhi? So the foundation stone of Hast Silp complex is laid, okay, and it has been laid in New Delhi by the Textile Minister of India, that is Smriti Irani. Which global cyber security company launched email fraud protection and automated solution to block fraudulent emails from reaching enterprises? So the global security company which has launched this email fraud protection, okay, and it will be an automatic solution. It's an automated solution, and it will block the fraudulent emails, means fraud emails, okay. So this global security cyber security company is Symantec. UN Human Rights Chief strongly condemns Pulwama terror attack. Who is United Nations High Commissioner for Human Rights? So United Nations Human Rights Chief has strongly condemned the Pulwama terror attack, and Pulwama is in Kashmir, and Pulwama terror attack was happened on 14th of February, okay, and in this horrifying attack we had lost our 42 CRPF personnel, okay. And now the whole world is condemning this incident, okay, except the Pakistan. So this UN High Commissioner for Human Rights is Michelle Bachelet, and Antonio Guterres is United Nations Secretary General. Who has been crowned Miss India USA 2019? So Miss India USA 2019 is Kim Kumari, and Vanessa Pons is Miss World 2018, and Katriona Gray is Miss Universe 2018, okay, so please remember, and Manushi Chiller was Miss World 2017. who inaugurated the 2-day long One Health India Conference 2019 in New Delhi. So this 2-day long One Health India Conference 2019, which was held in New Delhi, was inaugurated by the Environment Minister as well as the Science and Technology Minister of India, that is Dr. Harshvardhan. Dr. Harshvardhan, and he is MP in Lok Sabha from Chandni Chowk, Delhi. The first of its kind trip protector insurance policy was launched by, so the first of its kind trip protector insurance policy has been launched by HDFC Ergo. HDFC Ergo, and HDFC Ergo has launched this trip protector. Which country to move proposal at United Nations to ban Jaise Mohammed chief Masood Azhar? So the country which is now going to move the proposal at United Nations to ban Jaise Mohammed chief Masood Azhar, okay, who is operating from Pakistan nowadays, okay, is France. So France has decided that he will again, this is for the second time France is going to move this proposal, okay, and earlier the veto was done by China, okay, and China is protecting Jaise Mohammed chief Masood Azhar, okay, and P5 nations are France, USA, UK, Russia and China, okay. The month long Festival of India in Nepal started in, so the month long Festival of India in Nepal had started in Kathmandu, in the capital of Nepal, Kathmandu, and the Nepal Prime Minister is Khadga Prasad Sarma Olli and Nepal President is Vidya Devi Bhandari. Who became a Sportsman of the Year in Lawrence World Sport Awards 2019? So a Sportsman of the Year in Lawrence World Sport Award 2019 is Novak Djokovic. Novak Djokovic, he is from Serbia, okay, and Serbia capital is Belgrade, okay, and the currency is dinar. And Simone Biles, she is a sports woman of the year and she is a gymnast, okay, and Tiger Woods has been conferred with comeback of the year, okay, comeback of the year, so please remember, and he is a golfer. Who becomes first women president of Astronomical Society of India? So the first time in the history, the first women president of Astronomical Society of India has been appointed, okay, and she is G.C. Anupama. G.C. Anupama, and for the first time in the history, she has been appointed, okay. So first women president of Astronomical Society of India is G.C. Anupama. Bandikut, a drainage cleaning robot, has been introduced for first time in India in which state? So Bandikut is a drainage cleaning robot, okay, and it has been introduced for the first time in the state of Tamil Nadu, and it has been introduced by the Municipal Corporation of Chennai, okay, so it's Tamil Nadu. Namwar Singh passes away at the age of 92. He was a, so Namwar Singh has passed away this morning, and he has passed away at the age of 92, okay, and he was a poet. He was a poet. So this was the current affairs for today. I hope you had liked this. Please subscribe my channel, please comment, and thank you for your time. Have a nice day.